Hello, everybody. Welcome to the third and probably final installment of the Somnium arc in The Strange. This is episode 8 of my campaign called Tabula Rasa. I'm joined by Ed playing Gil, Brittany playing Natalie, Jeff playing Sarah, the daughter of Richard playing Jean, not his actual daughter, Jean's daughter.
Wait, what?
And then, Hippo is playing K.
Bet.
Or Vampire Hunter K. In, well, it's not Vampire Hunter K now. They're on Earth, so it's regular K.
Welcome to Earth.
Earth.
One who's just regular slutty instead of vampire slutty.
She's not slutty. She is special, though.
I mean, you know, a little from column A, a little from column B, I guess.
It's a Lost Boys gift.
I know it is. I'm aware of what it's from. When we last left yesterday, I'm not used to running the same game 2 days in a row since like 10 years ago or more. When we last left, the team was on Earth after dropping off, dropping off Rosa with some of the scientists from the estate. And you guys were having a conversation with Cade. And I'm not sure if you guys made a hard and fast decision about what you were going to do with her. Or about her. Or if you guys were going to be acting immediately or not.
Well, I think we wanted to act immediately.
Sure.
She has limited time. Before her brain damage and such.
Not sleeping is bad for you.
Considering either finding what's his face, Hereditas, in Innsmouth, or trying to come up with a scheme to just sort of trap and kill the creature in the gloaming.
What do we need Hereditas for?
He knows of a recursion that is very much based on pure light and is very heaven-like, and we might be able to take her there and cure her, or maybe if the creature tries to take her from there, he'll get burned or something. That was kind of a long shot. If we think we can actually kill it, we might try to do that. But it sort of seemed like we might need to be smart about how we trap it and track it down.
These are all truthful statements. Nice. Also, to make things simple, it seemed like the times relatively lined up between here and gloaming, because otherwise it would be complicated and everyone might die.
Oh, we don't want that.
I mean, we're kind of safe. It's just.
I mean, other things might die.
No. I mean, if you translate back and it's daylight, three of the members of the party would be taking something like 10 damage a round.
Well, wait, what happens if you... Is there a thing about translating back and forth?
No, because of the daylight. If it was daylight out, you have vampires.
Do we know anything about, like, a space-time continuum?
Like I said, for ease of use, the time between the gloaming and Earth is about the same.
So we have to wait.
Yeah, when you guys got back here, it was maybe 1 o'clock when you got back to Earth. And then you flew for 4 hours, and it's been maybe an hour since then.
Go to bed, don't tell Rosa.
Hashtag don't tell Rosa.
Are you guys going to sleep until night? I remember some of you talked about going and doing things during the day.
I
feel like we wanted to research something before we went to bed.
We have to keep Rosa up, don't we?
Researchers are apparently doing that for now.
Apparently.
You're gonna have to keep me up all night.
Well, you put it that way, I mean. Damn it, I can't remember what we wanted to research.
Innsmouth? Maybe?
Did we want to look into anything else with Plan B?
yeah, that's
mentioned that recursion.
All
no.
Right, let's go over our options. So there's two main options here. One of them is we go to Innsmouth and find this character that Sarah has heard about, because they might be able to lead us to a recursion that could help. The other one is, now that they're separated, we go back and try to kill the Shadowcaster. Those are the two major options. Was there another one? Oh, the third one is, we wash our hands of this whole thing. It's Vought's problem.
That's true.
No, you did bring up a third option where we try to mess with her head to get her to dream about other things.
Yeah, that was a fourth option then, I guess. We could add that. That was a pretty sick and twisted. Dean hasn't been sleeping much lately. But he did preface that by saying that is not something he wants to do. but he would explore all options of keeping Summer safe.
Keep Summer safe.
Sure.
Hashtag once again, don't tell Rosa.
Oh, okay. So I think I know what Britt was getting at earlier. If we want to do the trap it thing, we were considering having Dad and I go out during the day and lay some traps around where we think it might be sleeping.
There we go. That was it. It might not be a bad idea. Let her sleep in holy water.
Here, eat a lot of this garlic bread. No, that's not for shadow casters. It's for me. Well, eat it anyway. It's good. Unlimited breadsticks.
Unlimited.
We just have to set a trap and find a way to corner it wherever they're at.
Anti-vampire breadsticks.
I mean, I would not be opposed to sticking with that and eradicate the shit out of this thing.
The thought is that if we're pretty sure that it sleeps, and we think it sleeps in that lair, I think it would be pretty difficult, but we could try and lay, like a huge bonfire around the entire place to at least start narrowing it down.
Well, I wouldn't be opposed to anything. If you seem to have a lot of ideas, let's do it.
I mean, it seems like people hide at night anyways. So I imagine even the police don't like to leave and respond to things like bonfires outside.
Are the rest of you going to be okay if there's a bonfire nearby?
Oh, that's a very good question. Lee, would we know that?
You're pretty sure that only sunlight or UV rays would adversely harm you.
There we go.
And it would take a lot of UV.
Oh, that's right. We walked in that building with all those bright lights and shit. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Could we just change to like humans when we go in?
Nope. That was my first thought, too. Now that we have translated in, that is what we are.
Oh, I had a question about that.
Mm-hmm.
What if you have a draggable focus?
It's not related. Your race isn't related to your focus.
I'm sorry?
Your race isn't directly related to your focus.
That's true, but I'm talking about the... You know how we were talking about how we can't change focuses when we go back to a place?
You can drag a draggable focus.
And like kind of rewrite it?
I thought you could have dragged.
I think you can... I think you can drag a draggable focus whenever you go there, but you'll revert back to your original focus if you go there
from somewhere else
and don't drag it and don't drag a focus with you.
Got it. So we have ones that are locked in as our focus for the area, but if we have a draggable focus, we can bring it with us if we're coming from a place that has that focus. Like, for instance, I have a draggable focus in Earth. Mm-hmm. If I went somewhere, I can bring that focus with me to any place as long as I'm going from Earth to that place.
Mm-hmm.
But if I'm going from like Arden to somewhere else, I can't somehow take the Earth focus with me. I got it. I don't know. We can look into it more, I guess, later, but I was curious.
I guess the best thing we could do is go there and assess the situation. Problem is we have to wait for night. That's the shitty part.
It's fine.
Well, meantime, we can look into Shadowcasters as much as possible and try to think of some, tactical ways to corner it.
I think we should leave Plan B as Plan B. And, we'll go there now and start trying to set up as subtly as we can. And then if the whole thing doesn't work out, then we can still go try and find Hereditas.
Okay. If you want to try something a little... No, we can't leave them behind. I had an idea, like, one of us could go with you and be maybe heavily covered in something, so to try to block any sunlight. So this way you guys could at least get there, because you can't get there, just the two of you.
Yeah, we can. We're fine.
How are you going to translate?
Oh, no,
you
no.
You can translate by yourself, for what it's worth.
Oh, I did not know that. I thought you needed at least three.
No, you need three if you want all the specials.
Yeah.
But the thing is that we can all translate there, and then you guys can, you know, go to a hotel and hang out or something.
Oh, we'd have to cover ourselves heavily.
Do we know where we'll appear?
You'll appear in the last place that you were, which was in the industrial park.
We lose a lot of... How much are we going to lose per round is the question.
How bad does
Five damage per round ignores armor.
That's the sunlight?
That's bad. Mm-hmm. That's really bad.
What's the disadvantage to not having a spinner?
I believe they hasten. It would take an hour instead of 10 minutes or something.
Oh, okay. That's what bad. It is. We're doing a waiting game anyways. But what is the trick without a vector? Because they're not going to have a vector.
Without a vector, it's easing. Which means that that's the paradox thing. If you have a vector, you acclimate in one round. If you don't have a vector, you acclimate in 10 minutes.
10 minutes should be fine.
For what it's worth, the trick is that somebody else can ease the translation, but if you have no one easing the translation, it takes an hour to acclimate, which basically affects how effective you are when you get there.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody eases, then it takes 10 minutes, and if a vector eases, it takes one round. With a with the spinner and etc., I think it takes if you have nobody hastening, it takes 4 hours. Translate. If you have somebody hastening that's not a spinner, so if you have two PCs, one initiating and one easing, then it will be 4 hours to translate, and one round if he is easing it.
They'll have a paradox and two spinners.
So they would have so it would take them 10 minutes to translate and 10 minutes to acclimate.
Granted, they're basically in his lair, so that is not ideal.
That is true. If you are completely encapsulated by something, that is to say, if literally all of your skin and flesh is covered, and you go out in direct sunlight, then your armor from whatever you're wearing will apply, but it will still be doing the damage to you. If literally any of your skin is visible or anything like that, or any non-armored surface of your body is touching sunlight, you will take full damage.
Yeah.
It's not great.
No.
So, for what it's worth, during acclimation, a PC is unable to access any focus abilities from the previous recursion or the recursion you just entered. Unless the focus is the same because the PC dragged it.
We need 10 minutes.
Yes.
Well, hopefully that thing's not there waiting for us. But then again, we can talk it down so it's not so hostile when we first get there.
Are you guys, are you guys still doing this in the lobby where Cade was?
No, I would assume we probably went off in a room.
Went and did our own meeting?
Sure.
Oh, I don't know.
Short of, I guess, putting them in coffins and carrying them one by one. I'm not sure I can really carry half a coffin.
And then
that would definitely work. At least you're pretty sure.
It's a lot of work, though. A lot of work. There's no amount of clothing or anything we could wear that could get us through that, is there, Lee?
If you were completely covered by whatever you were wearing, like a hazmat suit or something like that, then your armor would apply. But you would still be taking the damage for as long as you're out in it, so...
We might as well just...
If you move fast, there are buildings in that area. The place that you translated from was a... you were on the second floor, which was mostly open. The first floor was completely enclosed.
No.
There are other buildings that have mostly completed first floor buildings also. And if you were to get out of the industrial park, there are buildings nearby. There's a hotel maybe a couple blocks away.
Do we know anything about what Shadowcasters do during, I guess?
Nope. You could maybe do some research.
Oh yeah, that's something that we were doing, Britt. When you said weren't we doing research or something like that? It wasn't for Innsmouth. It was because we were learning about Shadowcaster. I thought maybe that's
sounds right.
I could have sworn that's what it actually was.
Yeah, let's try to find out if they're active during the day.
Sure. Someone can roll. Whoever's doing this research can roll intellect at a difficulty of 5.
Hey,
someone is helping them, the people helping would count as assets.
I would like to help.
Is it what?
A new day? Did we sleep? We slept, right?
No. I mean, you slept before you confronted the Shadowcaster.
Oh, shit.
Holy crap.
That's
you don't
how
need
you
us.
Off session.
So Natalie does some research. Natalie, the information that you can find is that Shadowcasters are not injured by sunlight. They simply dislike it. But during the day, they will usually actively find places that aren't lit, usually going underground or inside of like abandoned buildings or something like that. You don't think they sleep.
They wait.
Kinda, yeah.
Oh, well, all the more reason to maybe not go?
With that, Natalie, you do remember that, that using, keys and such that are keyed to a specific location can take you back there even if you've been to that location.
Oh, that park. We need to use that stone thing.
We did take it with us.
We'll just walk into the research lab, no big deal, say, hey, we need to borrow this to translate. It's no big deal. Well, it's better than potentially ending up dead. Not to make this
the park
more
is about is about 12 miles away from the industrial park.
I'd pay for a cab again or whatever we do. I still have that guy's card, don't I?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Or something like it, yes.
Yeah. Oh, it'll translate back into it, I'm sure.
Yeah, it'll still be a card.
Okay, so the two of us will translate to the industrial site and then leave there and start setting up, and then when the rest of you are ready, you can translate to the park and it'll be night.
Sure, that sounds right.
Let's try to synchronize, I guess. What time do you think you'll be arriving?
Oh, when sundown there, is the next question.
I mean, let's play it safe.
Quarter after six.
There you go.
Quarter after six?
That's when it was yesterday. It probably hasn't changed. Probably wouldn't change that much from one day.
We'll be there.
We'll
be very close right before a quarter after six.
Okay. So we'll start translating it an hour before, because I think that's how long it's going. No, we hasten it.
It'll take with a spinner hastening, it will take 10 minutes to translate.
There we go. Okay.
With nobody hastening, it takes 4 hours. A completely raw translation, if somebody was doing it who was none of the types, would get one roll because of no paradox, would get they would have an hour to acclimate, and it would take 4 hours to translate.
Well, I suppose best of luck, and we'll do what we can, and we'll see you guys later on in the evening.
Sounds good. I guess, if you think it'll translate over, you might, be able to acquire some sort of, special weapons. I don't think this thing's hurt by anything in particular, just in case.
Would I have picked up anything in my research, Lee?
Nothing in particular that would hurt it.
No. Okay. It's basically a massive something, so just start doing damage to it.
Yeah, the descriptions that you found are ghostly, skeletal, robed, that sort of thing.
Great. All right.
Hey, Lee, is there an equipment section in the...
There is, yes. It is in the at the end of the character creation. Chapter 7 is equipment.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Alright. So what are you guys gonna do?
Well, it sounds like after we did some of that research, is it daytime now, or is this still the day that we got back?
It's like 5:30 in the morning.
It's already the next morning.
Yep. You guys went to the industrial park.
Oh, we hadn't slept.
No, you had slept. You haven't slept since meeting the Shadowcaster, that is true. Unless you slept on the plane.
No, we played poker or something to keep what's your name awake.
Oh, yeah. One of the researchers will come in and, they won't come in. They'll knock on the door.
Okay, yeah, we can, I'll open the door.
I'll say, what we've determined is that, Miss Flores seems to have been awake for something like 6 days.
Oh.
The longest recorded time that anybody's been awake, is 11, before things start getting bad. 10 is, pretty extreme. We can keep her awake. It won't necessarily be pleasant, but she'll stay awake. Figured I'd give you guys a time frame.
Alright. Thank you. We're gonna try to take care of the problem.
Good. She could use the rest. I'm sure the rest of you could too.
Yeah, no kidding.
All right. So, he'll leave.
Yeah, I'll shut the door.
Are you guys going to translate from this office?
Yeah, Natalie's office is cool.
I was mostly asking Sarah and Eugene.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you guys are going to enter a trance for 4 hours. Right. Let's see if I can remember what level the gloaming is. Sure. If you can make a test with a difficulty of 4 intellect.
Alright, 2 effort on that.
Neat. Yeah, you can succeed in your translation, and you'll arrive in the gloaming. In a familiar looking scene, but not super familiar looking. The industrial park looks a lot different during the day. It's a lot less spooky. It's still kind of spooky. Like, it's weirdly cold here compared to the rest of the places you've been in the city.
Mm-hmm.
You don't see or hear anything. The room is basically as you left it. I think there's a spent flare in the middle of the room.
Yeah, I'm not going to say a word. I'm just going to...
Yep.
Sure.
Not even going to whistle.
Just... Yeah, the first floor is dark but empty. So what are you guys gonna do? It's about 9 a.m.
Well, it sounds like we have a plan.
9:30.
To lay some traps, right?
Who am I gonna call? I'm gonna call
a cab.
Radko.
Yeah, that's his name.
Sure. It will ring a few times, and then a sleepy voice will answer, what do you want?
A little bit of help from someone who doesn't mind driving at an odd hour.
Well, this is a normal hour. I just do most of my business at night. I'll put some coffee in me and meet you, as long as the pay is good. Where at?
I'll outside the...
course. Okay, we'll be there in 20 minutes. 20 minutes later, you'll see giant, bald Radko arrive in his too small taxi, which is a regular sized taxi, it's just too small for him.
Tiny taxi.
Giant man. Yeah, and he'll jerk a thumb towards the back seat, and he'll go, where are we going?
About Home Depot.
Home Depot it is. He'll drive to the nearest one. It's maybe 3 miles away.
Yeah, I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Do I get my 100 crowns or whatever every time I translate, or is that just the first time?
Just the first time. You have the same
amount that you
more
left
or less. I haven't been worrying too much about like small expenditures. If you buy anything that's like egregious, I'll worry about it.
So I have the money I took with me from Earth, or I have the money I had last time I was here.
Last time you were here.
Okay. Sure.
So the first time you're there, you get that amount of money.
Basically.
Got it. Unless you have any other ideas, building a huge circle of fire was really all I had. We could maybe pick up some strong lights or something.
Yeah, we'll go to the hardware store and we'll pick up, those like painting spotlights that you put on the ground and they just like shine up and out. We'll get like a few of those and some extension cords, and we'll get a couple shovels so we can, like, if we need to dig a trench anywhere. And we'll also, I guess, maybe get a couple canisters for gasoline.
Okay.
Like, I don't know, like 5 gallon type that have like the big spout that comes out top.
Mm-hmm.
We'll fill those up on the way there. What do you think about that?
Sounds good.
Oh, and I guess a box of matches.
What's something that burns really brightly for a long time?
Well, let's see. Lee?
We could ask the guy at the hardware store.
Yeah, you know what? That's probably not a weird question for them.
Oh my god. Lee doesn't know shit about this.
I'll tell you what, Richard didn't know either.
Hold on here.
Like flares are just about the brightest thing I think you can get, like with magnesium and whatnot.
But I think we want to make like a wall or a ring. It's more like it.
We could just set a flare every 20 feet or something. Not a terrible idea.
This is, boy, Googling this stuff on the internet is not helpful at all.
Well,
why don't you know those, oh, go ahead.
I was just gonna say, why don't we get the gasoline so any, like, furniture or debris we find we can use to just set it on blaze, and then a bunch of flares that we can just set here and there to kind of make a ring of light.
Yeah, I mean, the gasoline seems like the way to go. I mean, it's a building. It'll catch fire if nothing else.
Is there any way to rig the flares to set them off? There's no way I have a skill.
Do you have a skill for arson, Jeff?
Yeah, she'll ask the guy at the hardware store. Is there any way to rig the flares to have them all go off at the same time?
He'll sort of look at you blankly and say, at the same time? I don't know. Do you have any... an engineer of some sort? I don't know anything about that.
Thank you.
He will recommend to you some brand name fire logs that are specifically supposed to burn for a long time. They're used in fireplaces.
Sure.
You know what? It's too bad is we don't know somebody with one of those like spotlight things that they leave at the dealership. Has like the 4 spotlights, and they just kind of like, you know, shoot in all directions.
Just to piss it off.
I mean, those are really bright to stand near.
Yeah, so it sounds like flares, blogs, gas. Yeah.
Sure. You're just going to buy as much fire as you can get your hands on, basically?
And those painter's lights he was talking about.
Yeah.
Sure.
You know what I'm talking about, right, Lee?
I do know what you're talking about, yes.
I've got one in the house if you need
it. Halogen bulbs. Yeah, let me go get it, I'll show you.
So you guys are going to shove all of this in the trunk at the back of the car.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to go to back to the industrial park.
Yep.
Yeah. Sure.
It's maybe 1:30 at this point.
Sure, I mean, we should get started. We'll eat something after we get started.
Radko will say, I mean, I can bring you something if you want.
Yeah,
if you want.
That sounds like a really good idea.
aren't. Yeah, he will drop you off at the fire at the industrial park. He'll also get out of the taxi and help you. And you'll see the Radko is almost 7 feet tall.
Wow.
He's,
he's a beast.
Yeah, if either of you spare more than a single glance at him, he'll blush a little bit and he'll say, I was a circus performer.
I wouldn't make a spectacle of him.
It looks like he's accustomed to being a spectacle. Anyway, he'll help you carry your stuff over there.
Awesome.
Yeah, that's nice of him.
She'll thank him.
Sure, he'll go to McDonald's. It looks like Radko is also getting hungry.
Yeah, so the plan is I guess we don't probably want to set the flares out until we're about ready to go, but we can basically lay a ring of gasoline and get various debris and fire logs to.
Yeah, and here, look, what I'll do is I'll worry about the ring if you want to look for some power, you know, and then I'll throw her some extension cords. And then what we'll do is we'll try to shoot these. We'll cross shoot them. I'll start working on the ring with the gasoline because maybe we can like throw some extra like branches and other things that'll catch fire. You know what else we should, probably should have got? Smoke masks. Because once this fire gets going, that's going to be very dangerous. You know what, Lee? Would it be okay if we had just gotten those two? They probably would have been
just
both
some simple
by
ones.
The painter's stuff and by the fire stuff.
Mm-hmm. You guys can get some of those like white masks to cover your
yeah,
face.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Just like a 10-pack, you know, of disposable ones.
All right.
The good thing that Home Depot has a no questions asked policy.
No, these yeah. guys know what's going on.
I'll try and get the electrical stuff set up for them.
Sure, you can find there are a couple generators that were still left around. They look like they might be gas powered.
Oh.
And
we had gas.
You do have some gas. Yes, that's true. You're not
perfect.
That far from a gas station either. But yeah, you can find them. They don't seem to be working right now. You might need to tinker with them a little bit to get them working.
Oh yes, I'm good at that.
Sure. If you want to make a intellect roll, difficulty a 3.
Oh, I'll end up wait on that.
Father and daughter creating a fire ring to catch a shadow demon. You know.
This is it's bonding. It's bonded. Yeah,
it really is.
Yeah.
Jeff, you can get a couple of the generators working, and do you think that they'll last for at least an hour? Couple hours maybe with plenty of gas. Considering they're not powering like a huge amount of machinery or anything, they should probably go for a while.
Yeah, I'll hook it all up, but I won't turn them on.
Okay.
I probably had to test it, run it out.
Yeah, I mean, in broad daylight, you won't see anything, but if you're hitting like a building or something, then you'll be able to see that it lit.
Yeah, even broad daylight is not really that bright here. It's mostly overcast.
Oh, well, there you go. You can also wave your hand around in front of it. That should make it obvious, too.
Sure. Yeah, Radko will, in the middle of this, Radko will come back with a bunch of McDonald's breakfast food.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, and he has like, you know, 10 McMuffins of various sorts, some parfaits and shit.
Yeah, I'll toss one over to Sarah and I'll kind of scarf one down while I've got the rolled up sleeves thing and the sweaty brow.
Sure.
Been, digging a little trench here and there and dragging things around. Garbage.
Mm-hmm. Well, there's plenty of garbage.
This is the largest dumpster fire this place will ever see.
At least the largest one to see this year.
Do you have a stake in all of this or anything going on around here?
Who? Radko?
Yeah.
He'll look at you and he'll say, the pay is good.
Reading his mind.
Okay. can read his mind. He is not a particularly challenging subject to read the mind of. While he's talking, he is thinking about how great it is to not be in the circus anymore.
Oh.
And that even driving a taxi is better than that. Awesome. Also, he has a boyfriend here. Seems to be the reason that he moved here.
Ebo, where's that circus music now, man?
Perfect.
He spends most of his time.
You're welcome.
Spends most of his time awake at night because his boyfriend is a night owl, and you'll see like a sort of a mental image of him who is sort of a shorter than Radko, but still relatively tall, handsome, pale young man.
Vampire?
Pretty decent guess.
Okay. Well, good. Hopefully, we'll be making the neighborhood a safer place.
I don't know if this neighborhood will ever be a safe place. Nobody comes here. Not even the homeless come here anymore. Too many gone missing. Yeah. You guys are brave or stupid. I can't decide which.
Find out at the end of the day, huh?
I guess we will.
So I guess how much time do we have before night at this point, after all that?
By the time you guys are done setting up, maybe 3 hours.
I'm gonna take a nap then.
Sure. Redco will take you. He'll mention that there's a really cheap motel nearby that will put you up for almost nothing.
Alright.
I'll say, where's the rest of the gang? Crew?
I had to make some other preparations. They'll be here later at night.
Alright. Well, you know my number.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, he'll drive off.
I'll make sure that I'll walk. Or he drove us to the hotel.
Motel, yeah.
Motel, whatever.
Yep.
Yeah. If she's gonna sleep, I'll say, you know, I'm gonna go back out there and just make sure everything's good. It's not that far, right?
Maybe a few blocks. And then the place you went was, the building you went in was actually relatively close to the edge of the industrial park.
Sure. I'll say, I'm going to go back and just put some extra effort into it. If you need anything, you know how to get a hold of me. And that's where I'll be, anyways.
Okay, I'm just tired.
No, I get it. Get your rest. You'll be all right.
I'm going to spend my hour.
Neato. Richard, what are you going to do while you're out there? Anything in particular, or are you just going to do general stuff? And are you going to be there when night falls?
I am going to be there until the deed is done. And I'm going to spend all of that time, kind of perfecting it.
Sure, you can, say, make an intellect roll.
Okay.
The difficulty of 4.
One sec. Sure. I'm gonna.
If you have anything pertaining to like laying traps or arson.
Well.
Or stuff like that.
Not really in the gloaming. I mean, I'm an outdoorsman normally, but that doesn't mean anything. That just means that I.
Especially for setting fires in industrial parks.
So basically I'm just going to spend effort.
Sure.
Bring it down to a 3. And, hope for the best.
Mm-hmm. Nice. You can get it done with, 45 minutes to spare before sundown.
Sure. I'm just, trying to make it more effective is all.
Yep. So, the rest of the team, You guys can wake up whenever you set your alarms.
Kill the Dracula. I just noticed that I said that.
Kill the Dracula.
Kill the Dracula. Jeff, who is your character from? I feel like I've seen that before.
Oh, it's... Integra.
Yeah. Helsing. Yeah, Helsing, the... his name? He doesn't go by Alucard, it's something else, right? It's like...
Oh, he goes by Alucard.
Is it? Pretty good. Okay. I thought the translation ended up not Alucard, but like off by like one letter.
I'm Alucard.
Helsing was one of those animes that Phil really liked a lot, and he would always.
Which was super ultra badass.
It had the police girl in it. Was like his.
Celeste.
Big tittied. Thrall or whatever you want to call it.
Oh yeah, the sniper chick.
Yeah, she was cool.
She's badass.
Ceres.
Yep. Ceres.
Ceres. Yep.
I haven't seen it in a long time. And I think, didn't they have a newer version of it come out? Like a movie or something?
I haven't seen all of it, but it's really good.
It's because it came out once every 3 years. Two episodes every 3 years.
Yeah.
My favorite was the priest guy.
I mean, that guy was really, really badass.
Sure. When I'm fully satisfied, I'll be sitting outside on top of one of those generators, leaning on a shovel, and I'll just be looking out.
Sure. Okay. The rest of you who are still on Earth. You guys are going to try to leave after nightfall?
Yep.
Neat. Who is initiating? Is there the roller?
I spent a 20 already. That's the hard one. I'm going to roll a 1.
I think Gil's probably the initiator.
Oh, I guess
I guess I'll do it.
All right. It's a difficulty 4.
Deal with whatever Molly's
bullshit. What's in her craw?
I do have training in this now.
Awesome. So you can lower the difficulty by 1. Mm-hmm. You get to roll twice. All right. Okay.
I can't hear you.
Alright, if someone could roll me percentile, probably Ed, but anybody can do it.
Ed can do it.
Yeah, this Ed.
We've had that one before.
We've not had this one before.
I was guessing.
It really sounded like you remember.
So, what you have... is you guys wake up during the telltale tug and snap. You guys fall unconscious while you're translating.
Oh, that's not good.
And you guys wake up in a poorly lit diner. You're definitely in the gloaming. You've definitely been gorging yourselves for a while. There are like 6 or 7 empty plates in front of each of you. There's a guy there who's in mild awe that you've been eating as much as you have. I'll say, Any more waffles?
No, I think I'm satisfied. Thank you.
Good, well, I'll give you your bill. It's a staggering.
Yeah, she's just going to pull her money immediately and just slide it over.
Sure. I'm pretty sure that you've been here for about an hour. You're not super far away from the park. I'm pretty sure you walked past this diner before.
What the
you
fuck?
You both can roll perception. Intellect.
Intellect. Send a perception and I started looking at stuff, but...
Right? It's a difficulty 4.
I do not have that.
I am trained in perception still, so...
Even if you don't have it, you can still roll intellect.
Nasty. I did not make sense.
Well, Gil notices. Gil, you'll notice that there's a, at the far end of the diner, there's a very, robust and, a hairy-looking man who's been sitting there and sort of is making a show of eating, but he's not really doing a great job at it.
Okay.
He looks like he's just sort of watching you.
Does he make any moves when we get up to leave?
Not immediately.
Okay.
After you guys are like across the street from the diner, you'll see that he pays his bill and gets up and walks outside first and lights a cigarette.
Sure.
What are you guys gonna do here?
Well, I paid our bill and I probably might go into the bathroom.
We need to get to that park area.
How am I feeling is what I should ask after eating all of those waffles.
Well, you feel very full. Not as satisfied as you would imagine by eating a lot of waffles, but very full.
Okay, so I'm not hurting from it.
No.
Okay, I'll take it. Apparently I was really hungry. And waffles are good to have, so I'm okay with this.
You're pretty sure you ate exclusively waffles.
Okay, that's cool by me. I paid the bill. I say we get up and we're gonna go. We're trying to make our way. I still have that card, right?
You do, yep. For Redco.
Yeah, as soon as we get outside, I'll give him a call.
Yeah, you'll hear Milo.
It's the other group. You can come get us.
Ah. He did say, or she did say, that you would be arriving later. Where are you at?
I would know the name of the diner, yes.
Yeah, you can give him the name.
Yeah.
He'll go, oh, gross. Okay.
Scene of you.
Richard, you stayed by the construction site, right?
Yep.
Were you there when the sunset?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. You can make an intellect defense roll.
Okay. Do I know what the rating is?
It is rating 4.
Rating 4. Okay. Mm-hmm. I am going to spend an edge.
All right. All
or
your
do
D6s
effort,
explode.
I mean. Huh?
I said all your D6s are exploding.
Okay.
Exploding.
I'm looking for 3 or better.
Mm-hmm.
Got it.
Ugh, nope.
Sure. Yeah. I will get back to you momentarily.
Sure. Is damage being done? Because I have armor against everything.
It is not damage being done, no. But you do feel something crawling over your mind.
Oh, okay. Well, there's always that.
We are going to move on to the rest of them. Jeff, what are you doing? I assume you get up with an alarm?
Yeah, probably alarm on the phone.
Yeah, you had about 3 hours of sleep.
All right. Text everyone. See where we're at.
Sure. You guys will get texts from Sarah.
You know what to say?
It says, where are we at?
We're,
simple.
In cab, on our way. Don't ask additional details.
Okay.
Leave it at that.
Yeah.
Yeah, she'll head down there, I guess.
Sure.
She'll look for Jean in the lobby, but if she doesn't find him, she'll just head down there.
Yeah, he's not there. Yeah, you can get to the construction site before the rest of them do, and you will see Jean is standing by one of the generators.
Hey.
Did you want to get to whatever?
Yeah, Jean, you, when you hear Sarah's voice, you sort of snap back to consciousness, and you have your mace in one hand, and you're standing over a badly brutalized generator.
Yeah, he's not going to say anything. He's just going to assess the situation.
Hmm. It looks like it's taken quite a severe mace beating. Macing.
Amazing.
Amazing. I might have lost time.
Yeah, you think maybe half an hour?
Oh. Yeah, you maybe should have come back and gotten some sleep at some point.
Damn it. I thought I did a really good job kind of fixing this place up.
The rest of it still looks mostly intact, but one of the generators with two of the lamps attached to it is definitely busted.
Ah, shit. I felt like maybe there was something trying to get into my mind. Maybe it's not safe for me to be here. We should reroute this power.
Yeah, that's probably for the best. I'll start looking for a different way to hook that part of it up.
I probably need it. Okay. You grab the two that were nearest. You can roll intellect for searching around for another one.
Yeah, let's do that.
It's starting to get pretty dark already. Even though sunrise or sundown was not that long ago.
I'll spend a point of effort.
Well, I mean, sure. I'll give her my flashlight.
Oh, yeah, you're looking for a three.
If she wants to use my flashlight as a, what do you call it, that brings it down a notch.
Yeah, you can use that as an asset.
Asset, that's what I was trying to... Here's something that Britt's playing.
Oh, Britt my God.
It was a big button. I was not expecting that. I'm sorry. sorry. Anyway. Good.
Anyway, yeah, was the 11 you?
Yeah.
Yes, it was. Okay.
Yeah, searching.
Yeah, you can find another generator. At this point you have a working generator, but it has no gas in it.
All right. How heavy do they look?
They have like a handle and two wheels. You can move them, but it'll take you a little while.
Can you do you mind wheeling that broken one over here?
Yeah, I mean, sure, I can do that. Lee, do I need to do anything special for that?
No, it's not that bad for you.
I imagine it's just a normal thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Sarah's probably seen this on TV. She'll try and siphon the gas.
Oh boy. You can roll intellect. Difficulty.
Wow.
Four?
Yeah.
Sarah watches a lot of crime dramas.
Yep, she's going to siphon Look at the that. Gas with her
Eugene.
Mouth.
Eugene, she's learning of... early.
Mm-hmm.
Spend too much time with K.
No, this is not the same thing as sucking on somebody's cock, okay? Siphoning means you blow into a tube. She probably learned this with her Capri Suns.
But yeah.
Blowing air into the straw and watching the juice.
I sadly did not learn it great.
That's how I learned how to siphon.
What you end up with is, well, not a mouthful of gasoline, but definitely some gasoline and a lot of it on the ground.
Ah, gross.
Oh, geez, Sarah, let me do that next time. You know,
yeah, she'll just hand it to you and start coughing.
But, I mean, some of it starts coming out, right?
Yeah, yeah, some of it starts coming out.
All right, I'll try to plug it into the other generators before it.
Yeah, you think you can get maybe half of the gas out of it?
It's good enough. We only need to run it for a little while anyways.
Bonding experience. Siphoning gas.
God, sweetie, I'm so sorry. I didn't realize what you were doing.
I'm fine.
Everything's fine.
Spit.
Everything is fine.
Trust me, building. It's going to be like that for a while. You're probably going to taste it tomorrow.
Oh, you're definitely going to taste it tomorrow.
Anyway, we'll worry about that later.
I'm glad that you put that in text.
So yeah, right.
Forever immortalized for some reason.
I have also seen my great aunt's procedure.
My great great aunt's son, and he had just come in when I was being babysat by her. Like, I don't think I was going to school at that time.
Jeff,
it
for
was
the next,
so hilarious.
Jeff, for the
so
next
dizzy.
Hour, any tasks relating to like coordination or balance or anything like that are going to be one rating higher.
Okay.
You don't feel great, say. And then, yeah, the rest of you guys can arrive with you can see two people working around a generator.
Yeah, I'll head on over. I'll tip the cabbie pretty damn amazingly well.
For
everything
we'll accept
been
your
doing.
Tip.
Sweet.
Gladly. And then he'll smile and he'll say, he's the circus by a lot. And then he'll keep going.
Still talking about that.
Art.
He was probably talking about the circus the entire cab ride, but we were too full to realize it thanks to Waffle Binge.
It was a pretty great binge.
I binge on waffles, so I'm not going to lie. Waffles are great.
Yeah, and he'll park nearby, and he'll pull out a bag of combos, and he'll put his feet up on the dashboard.
Can he do that if he's that tall?
It's awkward. They're up on the dashboard on the passenger side.
Oh, okay. That makes a lot more sense. Yeah, I'm going to go check out to the others and see what they're up to. Siphoning gas. Mm.
Yeah, you'll see... You'll see a trench has been mostly dug around the outside of the smallish building that you guys were in. There is a smell of gasoline basically permeates the whole area. There's a bunch of what look like Duraflame logs in the trench and some big lights set up around the building.
Smell lots of gas. She'll rub her nose. But they're over there. Let's keep moving. You guys doing okay? Sorry it took so long.
Yeah, I'm a little bit I'm a little worried. I think it or something got into my head.
You alright?
Lee, I feel fine now, right?
Mostly fine. A little out of sorts. You feel like hard to describe. It's like, well, I guess you've already been up for a really long time, but you sort of feel like you've been up for a really long time. Like tack a day onto your day of being awake.
Yeah, sure. I'll just say I'm a little exhausted, really, but I mean, I think I'm fine. It's just you know, it's
yeah, Natalie,
it was extremely invasive, I think, whatever it was.
She'll try to take a closer look at you if you let her. Can I roll something for that, Lee?
Mm-hmm.
Intellect, I guess?
Yeah, you can roll intellect, and you... it's a difficulty 2.
Of course.
Nailed it.
I do have healing.
Oh, well... Why don't you take a look, Kay? I don't see anything, but it
might not
be a bad idea.
I'll look.
His eyes look glassy. He looks kind of upset. You see you. It's dark, but you think you see something at the corner of his eyes.
Okay.
Okay, you can roll intellect if you like. It's a difficulty 3 for you.
God damn.
But you crushed it. He looks mostly fine. You don't think there's any trace of the whatever's happening to the other guys.
You look to be fine.
Well, if it was in my head, it kind of knows what the plan is, so I guess there's really nothing to talk about when we see it. We just get it over with.
Well, for all we know,
well, if
medicals.
It comes down to it, I'll protect you.
It's very honorable. Okay. Thank you.
She'll shrug.
Yeah, apologies for the delay.
Something.
We had a minor setback with our translation. The type where you wake up in a diner and eating 7 plates of waffles. I don't know what caused that, but I feel sick. But we're gonna do this.
Yeah, you can still taste the maple.
Can you eat waffles? You don't need to
suck their blood.
I mean, I could suck the maple out of the waffle, I'm sure, but
None of you feel like you like eating them was bad for you, although you don't feel like you really gained anything out of it. Aside from a weird sense of fullness that has nothing to do with being, like, not hungry.
Yeah, it's odd. Either way,
she's gonna start handing out a shitload of road flares to everyone.
Sure. I don't have pockets, but I will put them somewhere in my dress.
Look, when it starts, just throw it on the floor somewhere. Somewhere where there's darkness. We don't want it to be able to hide anywhere.
That's fine. I can do that.
Once we get the ring,
so what's
we can start tossing these around and filling up more and more of the place with light.
And corner it. I say right now, we go ahead and light this thing up. And turn all of the lights on, scorch the earth, and we head on in.
Sure.
Sir, I'll step on inside the ring.
He's gonna hand out some masks if they want them. Although Sarah's probably gonna not want to wear hers even more because she'll just be smelling her own gasoline breath.
Oh, that's nasty. That's bad, just, man.
That's just how it's gonna be. She's gonna wear it.
And when everybody steps in, Eugene's gonna light a match. And he says, look, if that thing gets into my head again, you do what you gotta do. And he's gonna drop the match in the in the circle of gas.
All right. Muted.
You're muted, yeah.
Yeah, the gasoline and the fire logs and everything in there, it lights up. Gene, the extra work you did definitely paid off. You think that this will burn pretty hot. It's extremely bright. You hear cheering from somewhere. maybe across the street. You can hear it through the sound of combos.
I'm glad that we can hear the sound of combos being munched on while this fire is crackling.
Yeah, it sounds like it's weird. It's like the person eating them has a really gigantic jaw. And standing before you again, kind of like before, there's the front door to this place is like gaping. It's a regular sized door, but it feels like it's predatory.
Yeah, I'm going to light a flare and I'm going to throw it into the door.
Sure. You can roll initiative.
Yeah.
If you beat a 5, then put a 10 in your initiative.
What is the,
I'm going to add
a rank 5 or
speed the thing that we can use?
Rank 5, yep.
Okay.
Is speed the thing that we can do to lower initiative?
It is speed, yep.
I'm going to do that. Wow, nice, Sarah.
Shit, Sarah's definitely going first.
12 or better.
He said 10 or a 1, right?
Yep, put a 10 if you beat 5, put a 1 if you don't.
Come on. Here it goes. Oh, it's not letting me save my initiative.
Number one.
I didn't have a token at the time. Hold on, I'm going to remove myself and re-add me.
Sure.
That's probably why.
No problem.
Oh, yeah, is that the guy?
Oh, yeah, Gene, you might want to, right now the Eugene that's in there is, like, your old token. I don't know if you can even see it.
No, I can't, but I'll add this one to the turn order.
Oh, and then I'm going to add this guy. All right.
Be right back.
Start this, bitches. And I'm going to start it up. Yeah, Sarah, you hear a combination of sounds. You hear a hiss. You hear hold on, if you could roll a d6 for me, please.
Yes.
What? Neat. You hear, like a male, a deep male voice, screaming in agony, and you hear, a sort of panicked, low-volume whispering.
Okay.
Coming from inside. From outside the door, all you can see is there's a tall, pale man in a trench coat, sort of backing up away from the road flare, like on the other side of the room inside. Inside is like one of those rooms that has like a bunch of concrete pillars in it. It's a very large room with maybe 4 or 5 pillars in it.
Sure. She's gonna stick with the group, and she's going to chant her prayer of silence.
Sure.
And, that'll be effective out to an immediate radius.
Sure. At this point, this will affect, like, the first floor.
Yeah, I don't know exactly what it looks like, but I picture it as some sort of, like, holy bubble. While you're in it, nothing sounds louder than a whisper, and you have, basically, like, an asset to defending.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
So it protects you.
Gil, it is your turn.
I am not muted, thank you. I can barely follow what's going on. My kids are, 2 of them are yelling at me really, really obnoxiously, so sure. Is there an enemy?
You can see inside the room that you're going into on the first floor, you can see, like, on the far side of the room, there's a vampire who's sort of he's got his arm up in front of the flare.
So there is at least one vampire in there.
Oh yeah, definitely.
I am gonna do a thing. Just a sec. I guess I'm gonna, for now, use a force shield, which is a revision that just lets me spend a little bit of points to get a little bit of armor.
Awesome.
Then I'm done.
Sure, the vampire is going to go, and he is going to... Not as organized as I should be. Anything ever. Oh. Yeah. He's going to pull out a machine gun. And it looks like a Kalashnikov or some knockoff, you know, reliable Russian. And he's going to spray bullets at Sarah through the doorway.
Fuck up.
There, you can make a speed defense roll. Difficulty 4. This would be one higher because of your gasoline drunkenness.
I'm gonna roll it. Bam. No.
I think it's
you didn't get the defense from your.
Do you get the defense from your silence thing?
Ah, I think I do. Let me double check if I get it. Yeah, me and all creatures. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, you can get out of the way of the hail of gunfire. And then you hear more screaming, and then just the rasping, scratching sound of claws on cement. And then the it is going to
be a dick. That's what I expect, at least. Dick moves.
Yeah, you'll see a you'll see a shadowy form fills the doorway. It looks a lot like this this blue image here that I dropped. Sort of skeletal. The light from within is not so much, but the you can see it's like a robed sort of ghostly skeletal figure with no like a glowing eye lights and no face. And you'll see it sort of gestures broadly with its hand, and some of its essence like flows out onto the ground, and all of you can make let's see here, speed defense rolls, a difficulty of 5.
Are we getting anything from the silence thing that I had never heard of until just a little bit ago?
What is difficulty that? Of all defense rolls is decreased by 1 step.
So it's already a 4 now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And I'm trained, so that makes it a 3. So I'm going to spend effort. Makes it a 2.
I'm going to roll with it.
Nope. Oh,
I'm gonna
try.
Me either.
Nope, me neither.
Wow, that's a lovely set of rolls.
Anyone who failed it...
I would have taken anybody's 6.
Anyone who fails it takes 5 points of damage as bitter cold lances up your legs, and it feels like it's creeping towards your heart.
Is it speed damage or might damage?
It's might damage.
Does armor do anything?
Yes.
Armor works?
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
okay.
Shit.
Armor...
Basically
light armor
a...
one.
Yep,
oh... I just realized, I guess still wouldn't have beat it with a 3. I have the shield, which I think you said can be used as an asset for speed. And
it can, yes.
And might.
But a 2 would not have made it.
No,
but
just
barely.
If only Kay had gotten her turn already yet.
and then, almost as abruptly, it moves... Like, it had come from the left side of the door, and then, like, sort of filled up the doorway, and then it backs up about 10 feet. And then, K, Vampire Hunter K, you can go.
Vampire Hunter K, who's a vampire. She hunts herself.
That's how Vampire Hunter D is, if you didn't know.
Yes, I'm aware.
So, I am going to, All right. I am going to start trying to bard up the place. I guess.
Sure.
Hide, 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 hide.
And I'm going to... spinning, that's an action each time I do it. Actually, if I get into immediate range with Sarah, will I be able to hit the vampire in
right now the first
immediate
floor,
range?
Basically, you guys are like right outside the door, and like right outside this this building, and like the first floor is immediate range. Like you could get into the room, but currently no one is in there.
But there's a vampire, right? Where's the vampire?
Yeah, he's like on the far side of the room that you guys are looking into.
Can I be in immediate range with him and immediate range with Sarah?
Yeah, they're both in immediate range.
Okay, I am going to kick a flare in front of Sarah, in front of the line of sight between the vampire and Sarah, and I'm going to have Protector on Sarah, and then I'm going to run up and shoot the vampire with a shotgun.
Excellent.
Just a vampire with a shotgun. Said,
how much was the might damage? I didn't hear.
It was 5.
I'm going to spend...
So, Ebo, when you get in there, you notice a couple of things. You see a werewolf when you run in to the left side, you'll see the Shadowcaster at the base of the stairs, and you'll see the, there's a werewolf who is in tattered, bloody clothing. Yeah, it looks like he is just finishing the process of transforming. And then you'll see the vampire is directly in front of you. You're shooting the vampire.
Yeah.
Neat.
I had a question about that, Lee. It doesn't say anything about transforming being an action or anything like that.
Nope.
So is it
For you, I would have it be an action. For him, it's a D6 round.
What was the vampire?
It's difficulty 4.
Okay, right. I'm lowering it.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, you can hit him. How much damage does your shotgun do?
7.
Neat. Yeah, he will take that and be suitably badly wounded. And then, what turn is it after that?
I'm going to say, now fuck off and die.
Wise words. Fuck off and die. Everybody's in front of us at this point. We're inside the light pit, right?
Currently, you guys are inside of the circle of light and outside of the building, except for Kay.
Where's the Shadowcaster?
It moved further into the building.
I would like to initiate flight.
Okay.
And I'm going to try to go after the Shadowcaster.
Absolutely.
But I'm going to try, instead of grabbing my weapon, I'm going to try grabbing him and bringing him out with me.
Gene's going to say, box him in.
You're going to try to grab it?
Yeah, I'm going to try to grab him.
Sure, you can try to grab it. You're looking for 5 speed. Or speed or might. Your choice, really.
There's no real benefit either way. I haven't spent much from my might pool yet, so... No, I wouldn't be spending from it anyway. Yeah, I'm going to use an effort to grab him.
Sure, you can try to grab him.
Of course.
Yeah, his wispy shadow stuff body just sort of floats through your grasp. You get a handful of a cold cloth, but that's about it.
Gross.
Yeah, it's kind of clammy.
Nasty.
St. Jean, you can go.
St. Jean, he's not in immediate with anything?
You are in immediate with all of them, currently. Unless one of them goes out of the building on the other side or goes upstairs.
And you said that if I want to transform, I have to take an action to do that?
I can't hear you. I can't hear you.
Yeah, it'll take an action to transform.
I will not be doing that then. Let's do... Okay, so here's what I'm going to do then. I'm going to pull my trusty mace out.
All right.
And I am going to spend 2 points of might to use a ability called... Let's see if I can find it. Use an ability called Mighty Blow. Allows me to attack up to 2 targets in immediate range.
Sure.
I have to roll against each one separately. What is the defenses of these guys?
You would be looking for a 5 on the werewolf or the shadowcaster and a 4 on the vampire.
All right. Let's see. We're going to do the... We're going to do the werewolf and the shadowcaster.
Sure.
And I am going to... I don't know exactly how all of this works.
Mm-hmm.
I guess because it's 2 separate rolls. I'm going to...
just roll twice.
I'm going to spend might. So I think I have to spend... Like, if I want to do effort, I need to...
Does it say make a single roll? Or
it says make 2 rolls.
Rolls, sure. So yeah, you have 2 rolls of might separately on them.
Yeah, okay. So, let's see. The first one is going to be for the Shadowcaster, and it's a defense of 4. Or, I mean, I'm trying to do a... I fucking hate this thing. The times 3 or divide 3. I'm looking for 12, I guess, because it's a rank 4 thing.
And the vampire is rank 4. If you're...
No. I'm sorry.
Shadowcaster is 5 normally.
Yeah, but it's 15. 4 because I'm spending
sure.
effort.
Sure, yep.
Okay. So it's Shadowcaster.
Nice.
And that's Werewolf.
That's also a hit.
Right.
Yeah. How much damage do you do?
Okay, so it's a medium weapon.
Sure.
And then on top of that, I do extra damage to specifically the Shadowcaster, but I gotta go to my PDFs shut off, so I have to.
Sure.
Yay, Acrobat.
Yeah.
Thanks, Adobe.
Absolutely not plugging Acrobat because they suck right now.
Yeah, I'm using a different program.
Thanks, Obama.
Thanks, Obama.
Let's see. 2 additional points of damage when fighting demons, evil spirits, evil dragons, and strangers.
Strangers?
I'm doing, I think, only 2 extra damage to the one dude. Because you said that he counted as an evil spirit.
Oh, he definitely counts as an evil spirit.
And I'm guessing the werewolf does not count as either of those things.
It is not an evil spirit, that is true.
Okay, so 4 damage to the werewolf and 6 damage to the...
All right.
To the other dude.
The Shadowcaster is... Okay, yeah, you can smash a number of, wispy, bony things off of the Shadowcaster.
Mm-hmm.
And it makes a satisfying crunching noise. Yeah, it also makes a satisfying crunching noise when you hit a werewolf with a mace, it turns out.
Sure does.
And then Sarah can go. All
right, Sarah's, I guess, I know it's the same range, but she's gonna move into the building a little to kind of keep up with the group, and then she is going to say a short prayer. Gene, what's your weapon?
I'm using a medium melee, which is a wicked-looking mace. It's a modern steel and carbon, whatever, polyurethane. I don't know, whatever they would make a cool-looking modern mace out of.
Yeah,
it turns out that nobody does that in real life. I think we should start a business.
It does sound really super badass.
After a short prayer, she will enchant the mace with the blessing of war.
Mm.
That's her turn.
What does
I
that
feel
do?
The war.
On your next hit with it, it will do 2 additional damage.
Ooh, okay.
Alright, and then it is Gil's turn.
Alright, whereabouts is the Shadowcaster right now?
He's inside, with Gene up in his grill.
So Gene went past the fire that we made?
You guys started out inside the fire.
Oh. I lit it when we were inside. You were dealing with your kids, so I don't think you heard.
Yeah, I guess I was picturing it backwards then.
Sure.
Sure. Would I be able to... The Shadowcaster is not a living person, I'm guessing.
No, definitely not alive.
I'm going to shoot a werewolf with a shotgun.
Excellent. Yeah, you can shoot at him. His rank is 5.
I guess I'll spend effort. No. I have training, so I'm just going to try to lean on that this time. Ah! No, it doesn't matter.
That is true. Yeah, your shotgun jams up, and it'll take you an action to clear the chamber.
Does it take an action to draw a weapon?
No.
Okay, then I'm going to drop it and draw my rod.
Fair enough.
There it is.
It's danger time. The vampire is going to go, and he is going to. All right, the vampire is going to draw a cipher out. It looks like some sort of a small dome-like device, and he's going to put it on the ground and step on it. So if someone would please roll me a d6 and a d100.
I hope this is Iron Gods all over. I will do the d6.
Neat.
Thanks. Neat. Fuck.
97.
Matt.
97.
Yep.
Okay. It's a 97
point shield.
Everybody can roll intellect defense, difficulty 6.
Wow.
Who can?
All of you guys. And also the enemies.
Okay. I'm trained in intellect defense.
Neat.
Me too. Oh my god. I hit it.
Oh, nope.
I'm going for a 9. Oh, damn it.
Alright, so, if somebody would...
Oh, I made it.
Would roll 3d20s for me, please.
I'm not gonna do that.
I'll do it. 1, 2, 3.
Neat! The vampire acts normally, and Kay and Gene act normally. The rest of you... quote, lose all inhibitions, revealing secrets, and performing surprising actions. So, any inhibitions you would normally have, completely out the window.
I'm expecting to hear some secrets.
Give me those secrets.
It does look like Shadowcaster and the werewolf are affected. Boy, I wish that had been a better roll. Okay,
I hate butt stuff.
The werewolf is going to go, and it looks like it, Gene, you're in melee with it. You see, its eyes look, which previously looked kind of cloudy and black, look, clear, and it is going to turn on the Shadowcaster.
Oh.
If somebody could roll a d20 for me.
Wow.
Nice. Yes!
Yeah, the werewolf will bite satisfyingly into the Shadowcaster's skull.
Nice!
The Shadowcaster is going to make sort of a hissing noise, like the air being let out of a balloon. And, I forgot how long this lasts, sorry. This lasts for as long as you remain in the area, which is immediate. And it lasts up to 6 minutes.
What's the immediate area mean, range-wise?
Basically, it's the first floor of this building, and like a little bit outside of it. More or less inside of your circle of fire. The the Shadowcaster, I would say, slumps to the ground, but it more or less dissolves into a pile of cloth, bone, and wispy shadows that float along the ground and dissipate wherever they reach like the light of the flares or the fire. And then the werewolf looks surprisingly calm for a werewolf. Shadowcaster is dead. Hey, are you gonna do anything?
Yeah, I beat that shit up through a werewolf. Yeah, buddy.
Hey, are you gonna be taking any offensive actions is my question.
Does it look like the vampire is
hostile?
Hostile?
No, he looks lucid and confused.
Alright, I'll pick up the flare that I kicked in front of Sarah.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm gonna point it at his face.
Oh,
yeah, he'll go like this.
God damn it, Kenny!
Back, demon!
Natalia? Are you gonna be aggressive towards the other one of them?
Can I tell that they're normal? They seem to be normal?
Yeah, they don't seem to be acting, like, aggressively like they were.
Yeah, I'll
look. The werewolf doesn't look, it doesn't look quite like anything. You see him like sniffing around, making a like what you would assume are dog noises. he drops to all fours after biting the Shadowcaster's head off.
Yeah, Natalie will walk up the cane, throw her arm down, and like, put this fucking thing down. Look, they were controlling you, okay? It's dead now.
The vampire will... Is anyone going to be acting aggressively towards him?
No.
I was going to transform into a werewolf.
Oh, sure.
And I was going to say, if they have anything else they want to do, they should do it now. If not, they need to get out of here.
The werewolf will try to sniff your butt.
I'll throw the flare at the guy.
The werewolf will also spend a moment transforming into an actual wolf. And then he will sniff your butt.
If he tries to sniff my butt, I'm going to grab it by the scruff while I'm in werewolf form.
It yelps.
Like a alpha wolf would grab a lesser wolf.
Yeah, you can terrify this wolf dog man. And it'll run.
Good.
It'll run up to the fire and then it will basically cower. And the vampire is just going to say, look, I don't know what the hell's going on. What are you guys doing here? What am I doing here?
I want to get out of here. All my friends are creepy. I have gas in my mouth.
Yeah.
Gene basically just says, the deed is done. You're free to go home.
I can't. There's so much fire. Fuck.
Well,
it's so
you'll
fucking
figure
hot.
It out.
You want me to fly you out of here?
No, just get away. Just go. Oh, what the fuck is going on?
Oh, fine.
I guess,
Where's John? John? He's gonna go looking for the werewolf.
If they're more or less dealt with, I'm going to basically take a look around just to make sure that we're not leaving anything behind.
There's an entrance, or there's a collapsed floor that leads down, like into a lower level. But you don't see anything up here.
Sure. I'd like to use that one power again to see if I can sense that evil directly.
No.
It's gone?
Mm-hmm.
I'll say, let's get away from the fire, but I think I'm going to take a look into its lair. It seems like that evil is gone.
We might have to follow you.
I suppose I'll clear out my shotgun jam.
Yeah, after a few minutes, the effect of the cipher will wear off, the mental scrambler. Mm. And
uninhibited, Sarah will probably bitch and complain the whole time.
Yeah,
the vampire is he's not affected by the scrambler, but the werewolf is, and the werewolf during that time will run up to the second floor and jump over the flames and run off into the night, leaving nice. His vampire friend going like this, like,
John,
don't leave me, John.
Goodbye, John.
Wilson!
Yeah, he looks like sort of weird schizo.
John did us some favors. So
Don John.
What can you say?
Oh, is his name Don? And it's Don and John? So it's Don John?
No.
No.
Anyways, I basically went into werewolf form so that I could regenerate.
Sure.
But I'm going to head down.
Yeah, you can head downstairs. In the basement of this place, you see there are maybe 30 sets or 30 bodies in various states of decay.
Mm-hmm.
Of various forms, like wolf bodies, human bodies, half wolf, half man bodies, bodies with fangs, the whole works. It's just a mess down here. You can find a couple of ciphers down here.
Ooh, hey now.
To roll me a percentile.
I will do that. Can you do a multiple percentile?
Yep. Give me, well, do one first. We'll okay. See what happens.
And then a d6?
A 78. And yeah, and then a d6.
See what it is.
One?
Sure. This is a small device that looks like it would affix to a ranged weapon. It looks like a bizarre, like a sniper scope with a bunch of doodads and stuff sticking out of it. It's called a sniper module. And for the next hour, this weapon's effective range is 2 miles. If you attach it to a weapon. If you attach it to a weapon. So.
Wow. I wonder if you can attach it to a pistol
or a sling.
Shotgun.
Oh, yeah.
His scope on a sling.
Just attach it to like a hand axe.
Even better, can I throw boulders with that thing?
That seems quite egregious.
Put it on your arm.
Throw a boulder. All
right, next, roll me another percentiles.
71.
One.
This one goes 3 miles.
This one goes to 11.
Yeah, this is a cat, like a beanie cap that is covered in wires. Mm-hmm. Roll a d6 for it.
Five.
Sure. The sniper module is level 1, but I don't think it matters. The reflex enhancer is level 5, but I don't think it matters. And the difficulty of any task while you're wearing the reflex enhancer is any task involving manual dexterity, such as pickpocketing, lockpicking, juggling, operating on a patient, defusing a bomb, and so on, is decreased by 2 steps for an hour.
Wow.
That's really good.
Neato. Somebody want to write that down?
So yeah, you got a sniper module and a reflex enhancer.
I have a couple curatives already, so...
You know what? Does our data sheet have a... maybe we can keep it on there.
You can't really,
You take these with you, so...
Yeah. Either sort of take them with you or leave them here.
Handling
too many ciphers, you know, is dangerous.
Can we trade them?
Oh, I have...
Yeah, you can trade.
I have an open slot, too, if anybody... Oh, if we have too many.
Ooh, there we go.
Is anybody severely hurt?
I'm back to normal.
Okay, I'm still hurt.
Things.
So...
Only down a few.
Alright, I'm down 5, so I'm going to use my cipher to ingest my small blue pill that recovers 5 might points to my pool.
Neat.
There you go.
So I'll use one up.
Sure. You can grab a... Yeah, it is a level 1 sniper rod module and a level 5 reflex enhancer.
And I'm going to... been my first dice to recover.
So what are you guys going to do in here? Yeah. The fire burns out after maybe 20 minutes. It starts to get pretty kind of lower. It'll be a while before it burns all the way out. Those Duraflame logs will burn for a long time.
We either check in with the black building person or we go check on Rosa immediately. That's my two thoughts.
Look, if we wait, the black building person is the white lady, and then there was. We're not planning on taking a side, right?
Let's go get
no.
a reward, though.
Salt is the one who said that we were going to get something if we killed this thing, so let's go get it.
All right.
Yeah, Isabel offered you a reward if you were to convince this thing to prey on code people and not her people.
Oh, specifically that.
Gather up the cloak and any remaining.
So we took
a side.
Damn it.
Yeah, you can. Salt also offered you a reward regardless of whether you you specifically chose to work with the code or not.
Right.
So yeah, you guys can, Jeff, you can gather up the cloak. It's black with like a blue trim. It's very light. It's kind of cold and clammy to the touch. It stays that way the entire time. And you guys can leave. Are you guys going to be putting out the fire, or are you going to leave it?
No, we can call the fire department, tell them that someone set off a weird fire at this building.
Sure.
That's what I'm going to do.
Set us up the fire.
I'm calling in an anonymous fire on 9th and Denver Street. I don't know.
Neat.
And just to advise, we did not start the fire.
An anonymous fire. Best term ever.
It wasn't me, it was someone else, I swear, but there's definitely a fire.
It's always been burning.
Oh, God damn it. God damn it. Stop.
No. Continue.
Since
I like this Billy Joel side of you.
Since the world's been turning.
Stop.
Yeah, you can leave.
I'm sorry,
and
I couldn't
go back
help
to
it.
The,
I had to say it.
Go back to the building.
Yuji, enough.
I appreciate it. God approves.
So do we decide if we're going back to the Black Mirror building, or are we just translating?
We're gonna get a reward.
Okay. Like it.
Yeah. you can head back there.
Are we walking there?
What's his name? Radko is still at the waiting outside. He's cheering.
He finishes combos.
In the middle of the
night. When you guys come out, he's cheering. He's like most of the way done, but he'll offer you a couple anyway out of the bag.
That is gross.
I hate you.
You don't. You love
it.
I
do.
Okay. Nailed it.
Sure. You can get a ride back there.
Okay.
He'll say, well, that was spectacular. Really impressive. So much fire.
I have no idea
what you guys did in there, but it was, wow. Really a lot of fire.
There's a thing that's been plaguing this town has been cleansed.
That's good to know, I guess.
Chances are something will crawl its way into that space, but for now it's clean.
Okay.
What he said. Black Mirror building. You ready?
Sure. Yeah, he'll take you there.
Cool.
And then hearing like a song or something, I don't know. Anyway, you guys can head inside. The security guard is there, it's the same guy.
We need to go up.
37.
Alright. I'll need to call. And he'll step back behind the desk and pick up a phone. He'll chat for a moment and then he'll say, "Yeah, go to the elevator."
All right.
I'm gonna hit 37 and I'm gonna hit the buttons above it too.
Yeah, I get in the elevator. I don't know if you're waiting for everybody to respond, but I get
into. Yeah,
the-
I'm hopping.
You guys
in.
Can go up. I was reading something. Yeah, you guys can hop in there and ride the elevator up. And she will meet you at the, like, in the lobby.
Oh.
Is she far from there?
What do you mean?
From where we were?
It's maybe like 5 or 6 miles.
Okay.
You'll notice, upon further thought, the both of the two factions' headquarters seem to be about equidistant from that area. neither one of them is very close to it.
You know what's funny about being 37 floors up? You could probably see that burning building from here.
I mean, yeah, she'll walk right up to her.
Yep, she's wearing like a black dress this time instead of a blue one. She doesn't have it nearly as intimidating heels as she did before.
This lady's still like outrageously tall, right?
Yeah, she's huge. Okay. Even without like really big heels on, she's about 6 feet tall.
He's like, yeah, he's huge.
Hey, Lee, how long can somebody hold on to one extra cipher before weird things happen?
I don't remember what the rules are for them. I thought you guys had two empty cipher slots. You had one on
Gil. I thought only Gil had one, but...
Gil and Natalie have one.
Oh, yeah, okay. We didn't leave any ciphers behind.
No.
Okay.
Which one did you guys give me? Or what?
Which one do you want?
I don't know. Not either of them, really.
One was a scope, and the other one was the thing that makes speed tests for doing certain skills. Down by two. Natalie, would you prefer to have one of those? Probably the speed test one.
Give me the speed one.
All right, so you got the scope, Gil.
Groovy. Thank you for asking me which one I would prefer.
Well, you said you said you didn't, so then I asked Natalie.
Okay.
The for what it's worth, what happens when you try to possess more ciphers than your limit, one of the ciphers that you're carrying, or a number of the ciphers that you're carrying, disappear at random down to your limit. People believe that they are returned to the Strange.
So anyway, she'll hold up the thing to hand it to her.
Mm. She'll say, "Well, thank you. I have a gift for you then." And she'll hold out a like what is basically a you know, like a gift bag from like a very nice like clothing store. It's like a pink bag. And she'll hold it out to you.
I'll take it.
It's nice doing business with you. Thank you.
I'll
save a lot of lives. Yeah, there's a bundle of cloth in there. It's sort of hard to get a super good fix on exactly what color it is. I think it's blue or black, but it's hard to tell. It's very dark.
I'll look at it.
And then she will unceremoniously put the bundle of cloth that Sarah gave her into a trash can, and she will light a match and throw it in there. And
Does it burn?
Oh yeah, it burns. It makes kind of a bad smell, but she looks like she's enjoying it anyway. Yeah, if you pull the cloth out, it is a long dark cloak, but it's like a velvety material on the inside and on the outside. It is a blue so dark it might be black, and it has a hood over. I can tell you. Well, if you'd roll a d6 for me, please. Neat. It's level 3, but I don't think that's going to matter too much. Unless something like tries to destroy it or something.
I don't want to be a shadow caster. Why would you say that?
And if anyone wants to roll, if they have anything regarding like an intellect roll with anything regarding like strange information or anything like that.
I have strange knowledge.
Sure.
And you can roll I that. Have effort.
Yeah, you're looking for a 3.
Yeah.
So a 9.
Oh, I got it.
Neat. Yeah, you guys would recognize this as a shadow cloak. This is actually an Arden artifact. When the hood of the cape is drawn over the wearer's head as an action, the cloak renders the wearer difficult to detect for up to an hour. While it's active, all stealth and speed defense tasks are modified by 2-step in the wearer's favor, as are attempts to detect the wearer by in any other fashion. The effect ends any on Any round of the wearer does something to reveal its presence or position, such as attacking, using a flashy ability, or moving a large object, moving quickly, and so on. If this occurs, the wearer automatically regains the cloaking effect by taking no action next turn. It does have a depletion. If you roll a 1 to 2 on a D100, instead of the artifact being depleted, the wearer must succeed on an intellect defense roll or become hidden so well that no one can ever find them again, not even themselves. So, yeah, it's
on page, your own risk?
It's on page 188 for whoever would like to carry that sucker around.
Who is going to carry that sucker around? Well, don't all speak at once.
God, man.
It's good for sneaking.
It's good for sneaking and defense tests.
It's defense tests if it's active, but it's hard to remain active in combat.
But it's a constant item, right?
Oh, yeah. And it's also a very nice and comfortable-looking black cloak.
I mean, I don't know how.
We could toss it around based on whoever's thing is. What is it? Focus. Foci. Whatever they change it to, and if it works in their benefit, we just pass it along.
I don't know. I think we should just give it to Kay so she can stay covered up.
I don't want the world missing out on this.
I don't think there isn't anybody in this world who hasn't seen your tits yet.
I'm only God, and I've seen them
every day.
All day, or day.
All day, or day.
Either way, we'll take it with us, and we'll decide later.
So, in the bag it goes.
Into the bag. Let's.
Hey,
good.
Can I use this while barding?
No, that's a pretty conspicuous action.
Okay, because I generally shout at people when I'm doing it, so.
Yeah, I know.
I could use it in this recursion only. Probably pretty effective.
Oh, interesting. I did not realize this about artifacts.
Well, you can start off with it.
Well, there is something I did not know about artifacts.
You can have four.
Ordinarily, they do not translate. They just stay in the world that you found them in.
Oh, okay. Oh. So it's here in. Or is
which
this
would imply
ordinary?
That she. Unless you use an inapposite gate, which would imply that she did use one.
Ah, because it's for art. So what happens if we translate? Does it stay here then?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Cool. Does it just fall to the ground?
No, it goes into abeyance, which is where. The mysterious nothingness where all of your stuff and kind of your body goes when
basically
you
like a pocket realm, and then it appears on us when we come back.
It was the same place our clothes pocket and realm. Money do.
The exception are strange artifacts, like the tunneler.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's a artifact specifically of the strange, and it translates. Although it's not super useful outside of the strange anyway, but, you know.
I'm guessing we're not going to retcon the rod. Because
I'm not
going to
worry about the rod.
Been fired in every recursion, I think. So we've made history.
This is Lee reading the rules today.
Rules? What's that?
I know, right? Let's see here. And then, I don't think there's anything about using multiple artifacts because they normally don't translate. Gotcha. And then, she will not say anything else to you.
All right. Well, I'm going to leave her with that then. She gave us our money. We're good.
Mm-hmm. She has an enjoyable little bonfire going in one of her waste baskets.
We should head home.
Yeah. Let's,
Let us pray. And then he's going to take the Bible and he's going to slam it down on the table.
Thinking
ahead this time, we're going to go to a safe indoor location to translate home from.
This is a safe indoor location right now.
I probably still have my hotel room available that I paid the lady for in advance.
You did pay her in advance.
We just go right across the street, guys.
Oh, okay. We can do that. It's just that, like, we're already here, and this lady already knows about people like us, so I didn't think it was a hostile environment.
Yeah, but if I need to come back here, I don't feel like standing up here on the 37th floor and just appear out of fucking nowhere.
St. Jean will shrug, and he'll take his Bible up and clip it back to his chain, and he'll head.
Oh, pretend you didn't do it, and you can do the same thing when we get back, okay?
No, it's fine. It's over now. The moment
you guys
passed.
Can head across the street.
Yeah,
the receptionist would have raised an eyebrow at you when the Bible hit the ground, but she wouldn't have said anything.
Of course not.
I thought we were doing this in a hotel room.
No, he's are. Talking about the reception. Well, now we are, but the receptionist that was on the 37th floor.
How about the hallway? The hallway over?
The hallway.
Makes sense.
The elevator goes directly in.
If we translate in the hotel room, we'll be translating into somebody else's hotel room probably next time.
That is true.
Oh, we can hallway do it in the continental breakfast area.
Yeah, there you go.
So if we tell
the lobby,
right,
there's always a little lobby area, probably like near a couch and a love seat and a bunch of pamphlets about things you can do in the town.
When the fun stops. Pamphlets. The gloaming.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you'll get some weird looks because you're meditating in a circle in a lobby.
You but, sure? Because I prefaced it with, let us pray, and I slammed it open.
You get a lot of weird looks.
I thought you said you weren't going to do that.
I gotcha.
So who's leading this translation?
Well, you know that.
Ed's turn.
No, I did.
To go back to Earth.
I did it last time, and I'm not going to do it again.
You did hard, man.
We had so many waffles.
Come on, Sarah, you're a high roller here, sweetheart.
Yeah, you are a high roller.
D20 is completely bullshit. I look like a fucking nincompoop in this game just because I can't roll above 10.
Ah, you're a poop.
I will spend burp B, I guess. Let's do this. Sarah's getting tired.
Yeah, gas mouth. I'm surprised you didn't do a. I'm surprised
you
didn't
rolled well enough. Okay.
Damn. You rolled well enough.
I was hoping to play this song for a little while. Yeah, you can go back to the estate. You'll appear in, I believe, in Natalie's
office.
Office. Yep.
Now, if you lose points, do you lose the temporary points also?
What do you mean?
Like, I get 4 intellect for my focus in...
I assume it comes off the top. The good way.
The good way? Okay, good. I'm good.
Yeah. Where are you guys gonna go?
I'm gonna check on Rosa.
Sure. You can go check on Rosa.
Yeah. Does anybody want to come along?
Yeah.
Sure.
Cool. Everybody come along. Group effort.
Yeah, you guys can go to Rosa's room.
Okay.
The area that she was in. And you'll see some researchers. She's laying on a bed. There's like 3 researchers in here. They are moving like they're in kind of a panic.
Okay. What's the matter? If I see them move around, what's going on?
They'll say, no, we can't wake her up.
She fell asleep.
It's pretty unlikely.
So what's... So is she in a coma?
As far as we can tell, she's stable, but she's not doing anything. There's almost nothing going on in there.
Well, the Shadowcaster's dead.
He'll shrug.
When did she go under?
Maybe an hour ago.
And that lines up rightly.
More or less, yeah.
She still have vitals?
Yeah. She's alive, for sure.
There's no activity.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Eugene will sigh. Well, we're not perfect.
Well, we don't know. I mean, that maybe it has more to do with that totem. I mean, she's still breathing. She's not dead.
No, and she might come to, but I think we all know that we're responsible for this.
I don't think so. I think maybe the Shadowcaster was a symptom and not a cause. She's probably elsewhere, perhaps meddling with some other type of creature in another recursion.
Oh.
Well, maybe we can do some research about it then.
Dad, do you think we should destroy it?
The totem?
Yeah.
Oh.
I think we should have destroyed it a long time ago.
Well, what if we try to chip a piece away at it? See if that does anything to her. This way we're not just breaking it all in one shot.
I suppose we could burn the diary too while we're at it. It's not like anything in there is needed for anything else.
You can just try to rip a page out before burning it. Where are those items, by the way, Lee?
They're in the research area.
I'm going to go to the diary.
There's a sheet over the creepy-looking carving.
Let's take a look at it.
Yeah.
Has it changed?
It hasn't, nope.
What about the diary? Still the same?
Yep. The diary's the same. Oh, you know what? Now that you have interacted with it, this looks an awful lot like the werewolf that you saw. The carving does.
Oh, John, or whatever his name was?
She said that she had carved it after one of her excursions, she carved it specifically of an event that she had seen.
Hmm.
It looks like somebody mid-transformation.
I mean, it doesn't look like any of this stuff's going to be useful anymore, right?
You think that the carving would still work? Like, it would still function as a key?
If we needed to go back?
The diary has no particular anything about it that you can tell.
I'll tell her small corner on the sheet of paper in the back of it just to make sure.
Yeah, nothing happens.
Okay. Well, the diary seems fine. I don't know what to do.
One of the researchers will go, ah, it's valuable research material. We don't know very much about what causes this.
Yeah, no.
Her experiences are the best clue that we've got.
I'm tearing a blank page in like the back, okay. Like in just like the corner.
Like, yeah, he's like, he'll like breathe a sigh of relief.
Oh, I'm not going to destroy evidence or anything of the sort, don't worry. People get so jumpy.
He'll like roll his eyes and say, ugh, agents. And he'll go back to doing his research.
Researchers. Well, alright.
Well, I don't know. Maybe we'll have to see. Let's just maybe monitor this for a couple days. Maybe she's going through some kind of shock or something, and maybe she'll come around.
Maybe it's just a deep sleep effect from the point that she hasn't slept in 6 days.
No, there would be brain activity, though, wouldn't there? Doctor? Or researcher? Well, there'd
certainly be more than there is now. I mean, any brain activity that we've been monitoring is roughly akin to light dreaming. The same sort of thing you'd see in a person who's in a coma.
Do we know if there's anybody that's a specialist for this sort of thing tied with the estate?
You don't know of anybody who is. Vought would be the nearest thing to a specialist.
Okay, and Vought's still on his mission, right?
Cade said that she was calling him back.
Maybe we should check with Cade and see what Vought's status is then.
Sure, let's go do that. I like that.
Sure.
Hey, Cade's not that far away. And she'll invite you guys into her office.
Yeah.
She'll say, how did things go?
Well, the caster's gone.
Well, that's good news, I guess. One less evil spirit.
Yes, but Rosa's not waking up.
That's less good. One less potential agent.
The researchers were saying she had little to no brain activity. Typically, there would be some light dreaming involved.
Hmm. Go ahead. There is a chance, though. She has vitals still.
Sure. Well, I don't really know what would cause it. I don't know what their connection was.
Did we hear back from Vought at all? What's his?
Yeah, he'll be back today, probably tonight. He hasn't heard from his team, but he trusts them. I think he's gonna leave them to their own devices.
Sure. I think it'd be really good to have somebody check her out that might have a general idea what's going on?
He's big into that sort of, you know, spiritualism, dreamy sort of stuff. Those are the sort of people that he was specifically recruiting when he was putting together
right. Well, lists of... Right, the odd one is the same way, too.
Similar, yeah.
Moral. There we go.
Yeah. Odd one is right. All of those people are a little odd.
They're special snowflakes, I guess.
And Vought has a gift for finding those sorts of people. We all kind of do. It's, you know, that's why we were put in charge of putting together teams of agents.
Well, meantime, when he's not here, is there anything else that's been on the books?
Not specifically, no.
Sounds like rest time, then.
It does sound like rest
I'll
time.
I'll use it.
You've earned it.
Yeah.
Let us know if the girl wakes up or anything, then.
Yeah, she'll say, look, there's no way you could have had any idea what was going to happen.
Did the best we could, I suppose.
That's how a lot of things are. I wish this was more of a science than it is, I guess. Maybe, or a science that we understood better. I mean, this stuff has been around for God knows how long, but I still don't. I don't think any of us have a strong enough handle on it. Sometimes we're just floundering in the dark.
Well,
go get your sleep.
Yeah, I'm going to do that.
Kate, if you wouldn't mind, if she has any parents, maybe we should put some kind of letter together or some kind of social media thing or whatever that kind of covers that she's gone for a little while.
Yeah, I'll start drafting something like that up, run it by Vought.
All right, I'm going to go wash up and probably get some sleep.
Yeah, that sounds lovely.
Yeah, you can do so. So as far as follow-up goes, Vought will arrive the next day, but like 1 o'clock in the morning. And they'll get back in touch with you guys whenever you guys wake up. And she'll basically just tell you that Vought has virtually no idea what's wrong with her. The other cases that he's run across of people who are dream translators are people who just were quickened and didn't realize it or didn't know how to control it or something close enough to it. And then when they actually got out there, that it more or less took care of itself. He's never seen anything like this. So, he's going to do what he can, and then he'll get back to you guys if he finds out anything that's actionable.
Sure.
All right.
In the meantime, if you see anything out there, let us know.
Sure. That's the exploration, but some much-needed rest.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and with that, I'm going to end my pretty short session.
Awesome.
Fight some shit.
Mm-hmm.
The werewolf pretty much did a bunch of damage too.
Yeah, man, that werewolf.
Holy shit.
That werewolf softened it up. Like 9 damage.
Nice.
I'm rolling crits over here. So yeah, you guys can each have, let's see here.
Yeah, Sarah's gonna crash. I ran down to the wire on my intellect pool.
Yeah, you were so tired, you were bitching like a little teenager. Oh yeah, that's right.
Yes, it was because she was tired and not because there was a bizarre cipher affecting her mind.
Yep.
Eugene, also that.
And she's going to taste like gasoline for like the next 2-3 days.
Eugene would never have thought about the cipher for that. But he also knows better than to instigate anything when Sarah gets weird or moody. Because,
smart.
You know, teenagers, right?
Yep.
They don't come with instruction manuals.
So, let's see here. But there's some fancy rules for her finding. If I want it all.
While he's looking that up, if you've been watching along, we are House Rule Gaming. You can find us over at houserule.com. Tools we're using to run this, like the battle board and music and character sheets and all that stuff, that's sort of things we've created just for houserule.com. We're in a closed alpha phase right now, so pretty much us and a few close friends are the only people using it right now. We have a Kickstarter up at houserule.com/Kickstarter. Where we're looking for support and help to basically buff up our servers and enter a beta phase and start getting lots and lots of people involved. If you're interested in checking that out, we have a bunch of cool rewards up there, such as there's a cool t-shirt, there's a lapel pin if you're classy. There's also the ability to make like a custom emote that'll live on the tabletop forever and a bunch of other cool stuff. So if you're interested in checking that out, again, that's houserule.com/Kickstarter. And either way, of course, we'll still be on for a little bit longer here, but thank you very much for tuning in. And we'll probably be playing some drunken shenanigans this weekend.
Yeah! Yeah!
I'm into it.
Totally. Like shenanigans.
So yeah, each person will get 2 experience points for this
nice
little mini session. I believe that brings the total up to 7 for these for this little trio here.
7.
2 out of shit.
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 I don't remember what the total is anymore.
All right, so 7 XP.
It was 17 minus the last 2.
Tier 2, 7 XP.
Yep. So that's 23 total.
That makes sense.
20.
Or 22 total?
Wait, we got 7 XP for the last 2 sessions?
3, I think. How many did I give you last session? 3?
We also started with 1. Remember we were like 1 over when
Yeah, you were 1 over. Yeah, that'll put you at 23.
How many? So we got 6 in the last 2 sessions.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So we're at what now?
A total of 23.
Okay.
So however much out of 23?
Tier 2, 7 XP is what I've got. Meaning, everybody could have already purchased an upgrade one time, and we're 1 XP away from a second upgrade.
I thought it was 4 per thing.
It is.
It is.
You had 1, you gained
6.
3 last session and 2 this session.
Oh.
Oh, wait. 2 away.
We're at 22.
So we're at tier 2, 6 XP.
6 XP, right. Because last session you went up to 3, or you went up by 3 to 4, and then you got 2 this session, right?
So 6, okay.
Got it.
I need to keep closer track of my math. But
that's how math don't do good.
I say I need to, but it's whatever.
I'm judging you, it's okay.
No, don't
Brownie
judge
points.
Me.
Gone.
And then,
so,
yeah.
Still be able to buy one.
Right,
yeah,
you can definitely buy
one
yes. thing after your tier.
Yeah.
Your tier up.
I had
just tier it up, you guys.
That helped me blow through my points.
Oh, geez. Yeah, you can
oh,
go
you
through those things
effort?
Like real fast. Yeah.
I think that going to effort before pulls is difficult, or effort before edge is difficult. But it also lets you really make something happen.
Yeah.
Yeah, something does like a 7 difficulty attack, you can reduce that to a 4.
Woo!
It's like a
by burning all of your life force.
Yes, you can.
Don't worry, you're going to roll an 11 anyways.
So yeah. I wanted to run kind of a shorter thing. It could have been longer and weirder, but
it's all good, man. This is cool.
Yeah.
I've been sleeping anyway, so I could try to catch up on sleep tonight, maybe.
Sleep is for quitters.
Fuck you, Evo. Straight to the fuck you, man.
That's just like your opinion, man.
It is, man. Get over it, man.
Alright. I am lucky that the theme song that I, the main theme that I chose for this actually has a vocal version also. Winner.
Really? So apparently
it's from the Shutter Island soundtrack.
So apparently my vector like tier 2 ability, there was this one that basically it's called Reach Beyond and it says gain
everyone
training.
Has it, yep.
And so like I was going through all my types of characters, right? And none of them had training in anything and I'm like, man, this really sucks. Except it turns out that my Arden character was trained in 4 things that I'm not trained in. And I was like, oh, there we go. That's the jackpot. Next character that I make needs to, but it has to be like in skills, right? Not like in defense.
It's pretty much, yeah, not defenses, any non-defense trainings, basically.
Yeah. So,
you can use Reach. Everyone has Reach Beyond.
I could get perception in any.
Yep, you could spend 3 intellect and get perception no matter where you are.
That's pretty neat.
I'm certainly not working on Death House. That's for sure.
And I can't tell if you're being sarcastic or whatever. I'm not sure with you
anymore. I just gave up.
Don't toy with my heartstrings, man. Jeff does that enough already.
Death House is
shit.
Death House is what I named my heart.
I found how you can grab images out of a PDF. No thanks to Acrobat Reader.
I've been using this other one that that Jeff told me about called PDF Lite. It's great.
You know what I used? Print Screen Lite.
Print Screen Lite.
Oh, I would like to know about this.
Today's household session is brought to you by Adobe Acrobat.
I would know it's not. I'd like to know about PDF Lite. That's what this house rule session is dedicating its time to.
It is Foxit Phantom what you use?
It's pronounced Pedialyte, and it's a electrolyte fluid for kids.
Yeah. I use the unflavored version for my dog when he gets stomach aches.
Foxit Phantom is what came on this computer when I acquired it. And it took me a very long time to realize that that was what that was.
It sounds shady, man.
It works fine.
Yeah, it's gonna
for some reason you're breaking up in a way that you don't know. It's weird. It's
because
like
of my muting thing is broken. That's why. Anyway, it's gonna ask you to install some shit that you don't want to install.
Like what twice.
I'm guessing it's this one that I want.
It is. Yep.
Download now. It's free. Here's the thing that I don't like about downloading things from websites is that there's usually like multiple download places and they're not all for the thing.
Yeah, it's just
you
the
want.
Top one.
Yeah.
So when you click download now, it's free. Mm-hmm. Skip that.
The internet's a scam.
Skip it again. There you go. When you go to install, it's going to give you some more shenanigans just like that.
So we're kind of winding down here. Just to reiterate, we're going to be playing again this weekend, probably Friday.
Not the Strange again.
Right.
No.
Probably Friday. We're going to be playing some DD&D, is what we're calling it. It's Drunk Dungeons & Dragons, and... we're going to be drinking and having a good time and playing some really super, super serious stuff.
Is there anything in particular we need to do to play this?
You need to bring your books. Yep. You want your books handy. And that's and drinks. Probably a drink that isn't a shot.
Sorry, is this
are we using our main characters?
Are you
characters?
Giving characters to us? Or
I have characters. Yeah.
Oh.
Ah.
We're so fucked.
Anyhow, I want Leonard. You mean Leonard?
There is Leonard. One that Len is part of their name. So, so anyway, this weekend, tune into that. We'll be posting online and stuff at House Rule on Twitter and Facebook to let you guys know when that's gonna be exactly.
Is his name Arlen?
No.
Are we playing with
no,
the giant?
No, it's Lenny.
So,
Lammering Lenny.
Oh, Jeff, what are you doing to us?
Y'all take care, and we'll see you this weekend, hopefully.
Later.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching.
Bye.
Good night.
Thanks for watching. Come say hi.